Hi, I'm Seth Rotenberger, and today I am going to show you how to utilize shape constraints in topology optimization to achieve optimized results that are more in line with different types of manufacturing processes. I already have an optimized part loaded into the design space. This part has forces pulling on the three sides of the model and no shape constraints applied. You can see that there are several crevices and overhangs that would make this part difficult to cast and manufacture. Let's make some design changes to the model so that it can more easily be manufactured using traditional methods. To do this, we are going to open a second study with all the same geometry and forces loaded from the previous study. This time, we are going to add a shape constraint called fill from direction. This will ensure that the model is built up from the base and could not lock the model if it were to be cast. I make sure that unidirectional is selected, and then select the vector that I want the model to be built up from. Once the part has finished running, we can see how the body has changed with the addition of a shape constraint. The model maintains all of the required geometry. However, the design now has no overhangs or crevices, but instead, tall walls that would make it much more practical to cast. We have several different options when it comes to dictating the shape of our model. And you can see this in our third study, which has a different design than both the other two. To achieve this look, I again used fill from direction, but this time made it bidirectional from a plane, and then selected a plane that was placed midway through the body. You can see how this affected the model. The part now has a more internalized structure without crevices or overhangs that would prove difficult when casting. This model would be used to hold a load on its linkages, and it is very possible that something could slam into it. We want to make sure that our part could sustain that impact, and to do that, I'm going to add an acceleration load to the model. I'm going to simulate the sudden acceleration coming in from the X direction. Let's now optimize this design and then view the results. You can see how the design has changed to accommodate for the sudden acceleration that we added. Material has been removed from the front of the model and then added to the back to keep the model from deforming. Let's recap what you have seen. You saw me open up a design with no shape constraints and then compare it against the same model, but with a unidirectional fill from direction shape constraint. I then opened a third study where I used a bidirectional fill from direction and placed it in the midpoint of the model. Finally, I added an acceleration to the third design to simulate an impact and observed the design change. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.